Hi everyone, this is my first design team project for the month of July for Melscraftboutique. Melanie has a really beautiful Sibbet store with gorgeous laces and appliques and flowers and bling buttons. She's Melanie Santiago on Facebook and she's flarebyme.com on YouTube. As usual, I'll put all the links down below in the description box. And this is what I came up with. I finally decided to make another cupcake doily book. Let's see if I can. So these are the items that I used. So the items from my DT package, I used 8 of these doilies, the bigger size, about a 4 inch. A second layer or third layer, I used these doilies, really good value. You get 10 doilies in a pack. I used the satin flowers, the butterflies, and the burlap flowers as well. This beautiful lace. I used this lace. And then a lot of yummies, more yummies from other DT packages. So here it is. I used a satin binding, closed it up, and added leftover laces from a previous DT package, like this one came in the Pinkalicious kit. Added some bling hearts on the hearts of the lace. This one came in a package as well. The pink one is from my stash, and at the bottom I added some applique flowers with some resin bling centers, and it forms a lovely little dangle. Now my first page, as you see here, is the base layer. Underneath here is one of the another lace from Melscraftboutique. On top of that, there's the second layer of the white doily. Underneath there again, laces and appliques from Mel's store. This one is a doily that I also had from Mel's store, and here you see the beautiful resin, satin flower, and an applique from the Pinkalicious kit. Just all leftovers. This is another leftover of that applique, another leftover from Mel's store, the leaf trim that she had. Underneath here you see applique flowers. Here you see the leaf trim that I accented off with some little bling pieces. And the dangle laces are all laces from my stash, and some of them have really little bling, accented with extra bling pieces. So this is my first page. My second page here. Again, layered the base layer. Laces from Melscraftboutique in between the doily, and then started to layer the images, vintage image surrounded with bling from my stash, one of my handmade crocheted layered flowers. This came in the kit from my previous DT package, an applique from my stash. This is a little resin flower that I got from Laura. She's Laura Loves Lace here on YouTube. A little flower for my stash, and then appliques. And again, you see a luxurious number of dangle laces. One of the laces that got some light avocado color. Oh, I forgot to mention, on top here is one of my hand crocheted hearts and a little resin bow, and that came in the Pinkalicious kit from the previous month. Next page, again, surrounded the image with some bling. This is one of my favorite laces from Melscraftboutique, the flower trim that you all know by now. It's, let's see, because I finished it all up, but I should place an order, so it's this little trim over here. And then here is the lace from the DT package, and underneath here, again, between the two doilies, there's always another layer. This one is also lace from Melscraftboutique. The burlap flowers, I did took the center first out, added a little doily, and re-added the center to it. A little resin heart appliques that came in the kit from last month. And lay it down. Next page, as you see, the pages are chunky. That's why I bound them with the lace. My rings were too small. Next page, you see again the little girl. Little girl vintage image. And this is a piece of applique that I bought from Melscraftboutique as well. And I just chopped it up. I think it's a similar one as this one, but just use a chunk, a little piece out of it. Here you see the beautiful leaf trim from her store, the butterfly, that I accented with this beautiful flower from my stash, and then again appliques from my stash, and then in between the layers, again lace from Melscraftboutique, some resin flower, and then again a number of dangles. Next page. Again, the doily lace from Melscraftboutique, a leftover from one of my previous DT packages. The doily. The lace came also from the Pinkalicious kit. This is another piece from, let's see if I have one. Okay, this is the very last piece that I have. Now, this part I used as a second layer in between the two doilies. And what you see here on top is what I used here. Accented then the curls with some little diamondy bling pieces. In the corner, one of my handmade clay pieces accented again with a bling trim, and then I added appliques from my stash. And here you see again the burlap flower with the satin flower in the middle, and dangles, extra dangles underneath the flower that I accented again with the little bling. And the next page is vintage image of this little boy. Again, this is beautiful. A lace from Mel's store. I'm not organized. I'm so sorry. Oops. I have it somewhere, but I can't find it. Oh yeah, here it is. Another one. I'm sorry. It's this one. Love, love, love this lace also very much. So versatile. As you see, I just used one piece. These lace appliques were cut off from another lace from Melscraftboutique. One of those bridal laces. I'm gonna put all the links down below in the description box of what I used. This is one of my, this is a center of a doily that I cut off somewhere else, and I dyed it with distress inked Victorian rose. And this is also a layered crochet flowers cut off from doily from my stash. And this is how it looks like. And again, you see a lot of dangling laces at the bottom. And each time, as you see in between the two layers of the doilies, there's always another layer. And this is the one of the last pages, again the vintage image, surrounded all with appliques from Mel's store. Added the little crochet butterfly from my own that I made, and some bling, a piece of lace, and again this beautiful gorgeous lace, leaf lace, and again in between the layers there's a bridal laces from Mel's store. And then the last page is just a layering of different doilies, the doilies from Mel's store, and a doily that was gifting by me by Marta. Then this is one, the one from her store, this is one I had in my stash. And then I added again the beautiful burlap flower from her store. And this is how it looks on the side. This is how it looks completely. So it's a very big chunky cupcake doily book. So let me all know what you think. I really enjoyed making this one. It was on my to-do list again for such a long time. Thank you all for watching and commenting. Don't forget to use my coupon code Patrizia10 for a 10% discount. So Patrizia10 with a Z for 10% discount from $15 and up. So don't forget, hop over to Mel's store and use my coupon code. Thank you all for watching and commenting. Bye.